Morning, Sunday 27th of May. This is peaceful camping, we call this. Probably the most quiet and peaceful campsite we've ever stayed on since Croatia. There's no traffic noise, no wind noise. A little bit windy when we came yesterday, now it's completely wind still.
No dogs.
No dogs.
That's the best bit.
That's extremely rare, there's no dogs.
Yeah.
No dogs are barking.
So all we can hear now is birds singing. Yep, we're just having our breakfast here on the shore of the Salt Lake, and we'll get packed away and be on the road again today. Just another day on the road. Not sure where we're going to end up, but it doesn't really matter. Just keep going. Yesterday we did 80 kilometers, so I don't know. Anything more than 50 is okay. So we'll see how it goes. So that was it for peaceful camping. I'll give you 20 seconds of the peace and quiet. Just venturing out onto the salt before we leave. Oh, it's a bit, little bit wet. There. Camping on the Tulsa Lake. There was a small path here that went straight down to it, so that couldn't be easier really. There's a nice road here. You can see why it's so quiet, because there's no traffic whatsoever, hardly. It's a small town up there, but we could hardly hear any noise from that either. A few dogs, but a few times they were barking, so yep, that couldn't be better. Excellent camping place. Okay, let's start rolling again. The amazing thing is this road was actually marked as a minor road on the map. But, in real life it's a brand new road. Like we've seen in many places in Turkey, the condition of the roads is pretty impressive really. They all seem to be quite new, made in the last 10 years or so, a lot of them. So,
that's a problem sometimes. We would like to get off the main road and down like smaller roads, we never know whether to risk it or not, because if it's a road without tarmac, then we will regret it. But this was extremely nice, so.
Okay, back on the main road. This road just keeps on climbing. It's been going up for 5 kilometers now, like this. Hopefully we're at the top up there. That was one long climb up to 1,350 meters. It's been going on for, I don't know, 8 kilometers now. Never ending.
Never ending hill. But maybe you know Vissenbjerg hill in Denmark. It's close to our house. And maybe you think it's very high, but this is 10 times that.
20 times that.
20 times that. It's 8 kilometers up.
One hill. That's gonna be planned specially for us, just a hill we came along. We don't know how many more of these we have today.
Yeah.
It must be getting fit up after all.
Yeah, coping them quite easy.
Yeah.
These trucks that you hear, they've got quite big hooters on them sometimes. And they all hoot to say hello, or most of them do. Sometimes you get a shock because they're quite loud. And I think they realise when they're in their cabin how loud.
Now you can try to hear how it is when I'm waving to him, so you can hear how noisy it is.
Yeah, I don't think they realise how loud their hooters are when they're in the cab.
Yeah.
For us on the bike, it's...
Are you ready? Look now.
Okay, that one was quite acceptable. We didn't get here deafened by that one.
So,
a lot of them say hello. It's quite nice, waving to us and things. On the other side of the road, they wave. People pop and wave and things, yeah. That's what it's like in this part of Turkey.
Yes.
Okay, should we go down for a little bit? That way. OK, Okay, benefit of a big uphill is there's a huge downhill. It's been going on for 6 kilometers now. Fastest we've been doing so far.
Yeah.
So have a little bit of views on our e-run project. It's turned into a real project for no reason, but we applied a few days ago to the tourist agency in Iran. It's for Meta's parents and Pia and Kirsten and my visa. First we need an invitation letter. When we have that, we can convert that to a real visa when we get to the border or another place we can pick it up. But then we got an email back that all the Danish guests met as parents, and Pia and Kirsten, theirs has been approved in what, 1.5 days or something like that, no time at all. Meta and Jamie's, that was also approved in about 2 days. So now we just have to wait and see how long they're going to delay mine, just because it's got a British passport instead of a Danish one. So we'll see now. It obviously doesn't take much work, it's obviously a quick process, but now we'll just see how long they were delayed just because of that. So we'll see. Interesting. But we seem to be getting somewhere. And now the countdown is on to Sivas, 110. Really strong tailwind at the moment, making really easy work of this section, especially when it's such a flat and smooth road as well. It's a good road and we have to, a lot of kilometers to do to get to Georgia. So at the moment it's going quite well. Time to find a place to camp. Well, this is a camping spot today. It's a bit of roadside camping today. We just found a small farmer's truck just off the main road, you can see there. We're not far from it, but it's okay. We just need to keep on the road tomorrow to Sivas. So, nice and quiet spot actually. There's only the farmer, I think, that may come by. So. Yeah, tent's up now. We'll do a bit of cooking and then sleeping and then biking tomorrow. That's basically it.
Night, everyone. Now it's balloon party, and this is called Dude. And hello, everyone. I'm called Dude, and this is my little my air balloon, so I am going up on this air balloon. So yeah, everyone, you can see me. I am on the air balloon.
Okay, good night, Jamie.
Good night.
Okay, that was it from roadside camping. Also frog camping, I think. Need some frogs over there. Apart from that, it's pretty quiet, even though we're close to the road. So. That was another day on the road. Tomorrow we're on the road again, heading to a town called Sivas. We should get there tomorrow. It's only 77 kilometers, so that shouldn't be a problem. The roads stay like they were today. And we may even stay in a hotel there tomorrow so we can get washed and clean again and maybe have something to eat in a restaurant. We'll see. But that was it for today. We'll have breakfast here in the morning and be on the road again.